$10 million, that will come into play. So those are basically the elements that will cause you to be in a position of taxability on your bonds.
I've got a question for you along those lines.
Yes, sir.
We're paying $9,500 to the bank's law firm. Are they going to give us an opinion regarding the taxability of the bonds?
No, the taxability opinion will be given by your bond counsel. Not the bank's counsel.
So as long as we're getting the...
You will get a tax in
this one.
Yeah, this is what I used to do. Okay. The clause for the going from tax exempt to tax is that every issue that's issued for, well, since they've tried the 25, 30 years, most of the time when the Congress changes the rate, the IRS doesn't do it at their wish. It's the people, the bonds are outstanding. I've never seen one that, well, I've never seen it bad, but most of the time they'd be grandfathered. So they continue to take their debt. Now, in regards to bond counsel, when usually you have a closing, you have the buyer's attorney, the bond attorney, and our attorney will be there at the closing to make sure everything is correct. And so, I don't want to say it. They have to be paid. They don't do it for nothing. But it's a common policy. Brian will agree with me. Brian was in the business as well.
Let me, one other thing, and I think this is another event of taxability, or a gross-up provision, not taxability. And you've seen that recently under the new tax law, the corporate tax rate was reduced from 35% to 21%. If, as a matter of fact, you have a bond or a note in this particular case with the bank would then seek a gross-up provision in that case. They would seek to see to recover the amount of tax-exempt income that they would have received if, as a matter of fact, that tax-exempt or that corporate tax rate had not been reduced. It's causing a lot of grief in the industry right now. People are not knowing, many people are not knowing how to react to it. You, if you are a bondholder, are not in any danger. In many cases, however, in the new bonds and in new loans, and in some outstanding loans, there is a chance that those taxability rate, that gross up provisions, will be enforced, and it could be not pleasant in some cases for a municipal government or an entity has a limited amount of money to make that gross up payment. So that's the third element that Wes was discussing.
Now, I got a question for you. Let's say we need more money before we finish.
Yeah. More than the $2.5 million? The $2.5 million is not to exceed.
Not to exceed from
that. And we did that because, again, we heard that the construction account was going to be approximately $2 million. Well, we threw in the extra $500,000 and anticipating that there would, of course, obviously be other costs. But I'm not in a position to say that you can use that additional $500,000 because you're not, I don't think we're looking at those kind of expenses here.
Well, you always have days.
Yeah. I mean, that's up to you. But what we would have to do is go back to the bank and renegotiate the whole transaction.
Okay.
Does the board have any questions?
No.
Glenn? Rich? No questions? All right.
Thank you very much.
So we need a motion to accept the contract and the equipment, whatever on the line here.
Motion is second. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, motion carries 5-0.
are supposed to meet February 20th. I believe you said the plan to be ready for the March meeting.
Yes.
So unless any of you have any, anything specific for a meeting in February, we'll hold our next meeting March 20th.
So you may not find it here. March, well, that's what we're scheduled for the meeting.
Right.
March 20th, yeah.
March what?
20th.
Now, if anybody wants to see the plans that Mr. Evans and Mr. Maxwell are doing, I think the two gentlemen would be happy to meet with you and go over what they're doing. Is that your question, Jerry?
No, you know what's coming.
They'll come to you.
Yeah, you know what's coming, and I would like the board to consider this, and I'm asking it on behalf of Stan Holman. Those of you who don't know, he's a Quarry resident. He's owned his own engineering firm, been president for a couple of decades. He's now part of a large engineering firm, and what he has asked me to ask you is if you would empower him with intervener status, when you're establishing this design criteria. In other words, this would allow a community resident the opportunity to interact with both contracting engineers, report back on the design decisions and criteria selected. And so we have this independent third party who happens to be a Quarry resident, and then we're all on the same page. And so I'm asking the CDT board to consider that.
I sat and met with the lake committee and Mr. Holman, and aside from the fact that the size of the riprap and the weight of the riprap, which is what our engineers are going to design and give us information about, the actual design that I discussed it with Josh Evans and also with Terrell. The design is pretty straightforward. I mean, it's not going to be, I don't know how to explain this, it's not brain surgery. It's going out there and replacing the riprap, basically. And how we do that is how we do that. There are questions, and, you know, from the people here, I see all these questions about, you know, how are we going to design this to handle a hurricane? We're not. I can tell you right now, you're not going to design anything that we would accept that would stop Hurricane Irma.
Amen.
All right? That's where we're at. We're going to put the lakeshore back to a functional position. We're not going to put it back to something that's going to fall apart or whatever. And that's what my comment or discussions with the engineers have been, is that we need to get this thing back to to a level that's acceptable, that's not going to fall apart. We're not going to design it for 150-mile-an-hour winds.
Yeah.
We're not going to put a retaining wall up so that 900 residents have to pay, you know, $3,000 a piece, so that if you live on a lake, you've got a retaining wall, or you've got something like a spinner pole. You're not getting that. It's not going to be that.
Right.
It's going to be something that is engineering standard correct, and I trust both Josh and Terrell to come up with that. I don't need another voice.
Respectfully, I didn't ask you to prevent a hurricane or any of those things. I just asked you what we want.
I just explained
it. And I've never gotten that answer.
I just explained it to you, Jerry. You're going to get something that's functional.
You didn't. That doesn't explain it.
Well, I'm a condo owner. I'm not going to pay for something that's better than what we had before. We're obviously going to get something better. So that's why I'm just telling you my position.
Please listen to me. That is not what I asked. I asked to put a community member in there because it's one of two things. either you're going to come up with a design and he's going to sit here and ask a million questions to be satisfied so he can explain it to us.
I'm sure he can.
Or he's part of the process that makes it easier, and all along the way we're on the same page. I want what you want. We all have the same objective. Get this damn light fixed. And I'm just trying to say, how do we move forward so that it's easier to get it accomplished? That's all.
Prior to the next meeting, the two engineers will meet with Mr. Olman. You'll send them the design, or are you going to give them
to me?
So we have till March.
Yeah, somewhere between here and March, I would suggest, if it's okay with the board, we meet with a couple representatives of the engineer as to what we're planning. But we're looking at multiple alternatives, and then we're going to bid those out and make prices, and we're going to come back and present in a public forum with two or three options, where they are, with costs associated with that, with design of this meeting, we're going to have that conversation.
Should I answer your question?
He just wants to work with you. He has no action.
You want to meet, we're going to have a meeting.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
Mayor, can I ask a quick question?
Yes, sir.
What is the timeline? So we're 6 weeks till we meet again, and then when we meet again, we're going to discuss the, I guess that's when the decision's going to be made, whether we're going with A, B, or C. Is that correct?
Yes.
And then once we decide we're going with A, B, or C, how much behind that are the actual repairs going to start to commence?
I'll have to talk, I'm referring to.
Yeah, the goal is that when we meet again, we'll also have bids from contractors. So in the same meeting, I hope that we would be able to select a design, and then those contractors would have provided pricing for all three designs. So at that same meeting, we could also select a contractor to move forward. Now, I'd have to talk to each contractor. Maybe we put that in the request for bids that they identify that they can start within a week of, you know,
The reason
or whatever, I mean, we can dictate that or at least request that from the contractor.
The reason that I'm
there's
bringing...
There's no permitting associated with it, so it can happen as fast as the contractor can get out there once we select them. So,
I just want to remind, you know, we have rainy season, you know, on our front doorstep, you know, in the May, it's going to be here. And then basically we're going to be done and won't be able to do the repairs. And that's a big concern of mine, that they're done before rainy season.
I agree. And one of the ideas is set up so that on the next meeting we can choose a contractor and they can get started immediately.
If that happens, that would make me eternally grateful.
Yeah, that's the only reason that I suggested not meeting in 2 weeks, because we wouldn't have the contractor's bids. It'd be kind of a waste. My preference is to give us enough time to get the design done, the survey's already started, get the bids out, and have bids in hand when we come back to you on whatever that date is.
Understood.
And if they execute the contract, I would be probably teeing up the contractor in some way to let them know that this decision is going to be made immediately, and that they do want them to start within 5 days or something, because we'll write that in the bid, so they're aware of that.
Judge, how many bids are you going to win for this contractor?
Probably three.
Three, all right.
It's going to be hard finding a contractor that's interested in doing this, so I've already talked to two that are interested, and I'd like to find one more.
Josh, I don't know if the dots have been connected, but the guy that did mine just before the hurricane, he's interested in bidding it.
Is that Dragonfly?
I have his number on my phone. I can't remember the name of it. I can give it to you.
Tomahawk's one of the two contractors that I would hear.
I don't know if the guy is going to be working through Tomahawk, but I know when he did it for me, it was subletted to him from Tomahawk.
Well, do you have my
contact? I can give it to you for you.
Okay, cool. Yeah, we have to be careful too that it's a contractor adequately sized to handle this job. So, I mean, not saying the person that did
it. I had that combo with him and he said he can handle it. So, how?
The contractor always will say that. So, but I definitely want to get their number and talk to them about it. As long as they're big enough and they have enough equipment and staff.
Yes, Wes, do you have something to say?
Well, I just wanted to. When did we say the next meeting is? The only reason I asked you it may be. I don't think we need to set the date now, but it makes sense to be put on the radar that in light of the approval of the term sheet, that we'll go back to the bank, we'll go back to bond council, but there are going to be documents that, even though you're not going through the assessment process, there are going to be documents that needs to be approved by the board before we can formally close on that note, I believe. And I recall there, Clark, being a deadline in September for which they'll hold that interest rate for...
March.
Well into March.
March 26th. I think it was March. I thought it was March 26th. Let me take a look. They're going to hold it.
It is March. It is March 26th.
And what is the date of the next meeting we're giving?
March 20th.
March 20th. So I believe, sure, I mean, we could...
We work.
Wes, we could hold the meeting in the 20th. I mean...
29th.
No, but I mean, Clark, how long would it take to get the paper, the paperwork done? Can we do it in, you know, we're supposed to have a regular meeting on the 20th. Is that too bad?
March 20th?
No, February 20th.
I think that would be pressing. I'm not the bond counsel, but...
Okay, here's what we'll do. We won't cancel the 20th. Of February. And we'll leave it open. If we have to cancel, because we don't have anything to do anyways, except this, we'll let everybody know that we're going to slide over to into March.
I do believe that he can turn out the bond documents rather quickly, because he's just recently finished another transaction which involved your limited large community bank, so it should not be...
It's quite a bit. This is a short perspective. I see really maybe 150 pages.
Wes, question. Are we going to have to do assessment resolutions in February?
No, we don't need the assessment resolution, but we will. My guess is that bond council will want to, at a minimum, do what's called a delegated board resolution or some formal resolution approving the bond document beyond the motion we have today, which is approving the term sheet. So we don't need the assessment. We will need the assessment resolutions at some point. But we will not need those prior to closing on the note. Closing on the note will give us access to that 225. We will need to go through the assessment process before we be able to get access to the remaining amount of the note.
One thing, if that 225, that is the maximum that you can withdraw. I would suggest that you withdraw what you need, because I would not like to see you charge 3.05% on money that you're not using. And that will be effective when you finally close on the bond. I mean, there's no point in that. I mean, it's just take exactly what you reasonably believe you're going to need from the availability of 225.
All right, so somewhere down in the next 2 weeks, we'll let everybody know. Somebody in the back.
Yeah, exactly. I just sort of wanted to make sure we discussed that as far as the upcoming meeting.
Well, let's wait till we get to public comments. Board member comments? Do you have any comments? No? No? Okay. Well, now I guess we'll open it again if you have any questions.
Mr. Gober,
yeah, Doug Gober, site board. Just to refresh everybody's memory, this lake is failing. Long before the hurricane. We had the North Shore, and we had straight across from me on the east side. Yeah. I don't think anybody wants a bowl bay fixed. I don't. I want to get back to the lake. My dock's gone, but I can't boat until I get my dock back. But let's not forget that this lake failed long before the hurricane hit. And it was costing this community money. So I don't think anybody wants a bowl bay fixed, but there's places on this lake that need to be fixed right. Maybe the whole lake doesn't need to be fixed that way. There are places on this lake that need to be fixed. Or we'll be facing this again. Just a lot. If you get boating out there, because I know I dock rocks when everybody's boating. It messes my boat up. Even with the markers right now, the weights are unbelievable during the summertime when the lake's up and the boats are going. And it definitely pushes my rock out. I've been out there. People have probably seen me pick the rock up, pull a rock back by the water, because it's what it does. So let's just make sure that we're not facing this. We may not get another hurricane in 15 years, I hope. But if we don't, it's not, as a community, I don't think we want to be fixing this thing again.
All right, thanks, sir. Ken, Brian?
Can everyone hear me?
No.
Okay, no need for a microphone. Given the need to move quickly, once we agree that we want to begin engineering work and repair work, can we please look into what we can do now to agree the staging that's going to be necessary to get the equipment in? I rode by for roughly 8 weeks while we used the southeast corner of this lake and two lots that had not been developed to build up the huge sampling that we needed. We needed to float a barge in and then put a backhoe crane kind of thing on. It took 6 to 8 weeks. We don't need that kind of time with something like this. Did you give me earlier comments in terms of the rainy season, et cetera? Can we please give some thought to how long it's going to take once we say go to actually be able to get some equipment in place and where we're going to do it? Because those two lots are no longer available. As far as I know, there are no lots that are available for that kind of state.
What's your name, sir?
Brian Burns, Nick Ridge.
Yeah, I know what you're, I've asked that question a number of times. And both engineers said, we're going to, there's some lawns that are going to be damaged temporarily, but they can get them in. And there's a couple of people, I don't know, some of them said that the barges they use are pontoons that can be put in individually and then connected and then gone on. So it shouldn't be as long. And we'll find out once we get the contracts going. And the contractor should give us a timeline.
Thank you.
Sure,
My question was similar to Brian, but I was just wondering if the work, it may be premature to ask, but if the work was going to be done with the barges in the lake, or if it's going to be done between homeowner lots, because it's got a lot of damage here, and if it was between homeowner lots, we're going to be messing up a lot.
Yeah, I understand. I'm
sure it's going to be a combination of both. There's no way to get the material distributed the way it needs to be without doing the barge, and historically that's the way they've done this repair. Another job I'm working on, they're doing the same thing, proposing the same thing. Fortunately, you know, you have access to the lake, you can get the barge in, the other community I'm working, they don't, so that's the difficult part of that. There's some top bank repair that has to occur in some locations in the more damaged areas, so that's going to occur in land work, but the places where for the most part, the rock material, I'm sure, will be moved apart.
Okay, thank you.
When they did mine, they laid sheets of plywood out and made like a sidewalk. And when they pulled the sheets up, you had to grasp a crack for a day or two, ran the sprinkler for 3 or 4 days, it was kind of fine. And my whole front was 190 feet, I think.
Yes, sir.
My name is Beth, and I live on Maldon
Stone.
What is your name, sir?
Pardon me?
What's your name?
B-A-S-K-I-S. So there were very plenty of comments by two previous people. And it has to do with the timeline of fixing, restoring the shoreline before the rainy season. And as usual, the committee really doesn't answer the questions. So I am respectfully requesting some notification before the rainy season as to whether it's going to get done or not, in which case I have the option of fixing it myself. I am requesting that at some point tell us, is it going to be fixed or not fixed before May? I'll fix it myself.
Amen.
Please respond to me. I need a direct answer to that. Is that possible?
When we get the contract signed, we'll have a timeline from the contractor and we will let you know what's going to happen. I'm not Harry Potter. I can't go proof of that.
No.
But we will
not necessary. The answer is not necessary. What I'm requesting is when you have the information, tell us whether the restoration can be accomplished before May or not. It's a respectful request. That's all.
We will let
you know.
Sometime by no later than April. You gotta let us know.
Okay.
I have a second remark, and that's the following. There's a lot of controversy about the engineering, how to do it, what the slope will be, how to configure it. Nobody really understands that, or at least we don't. We're not engineers. So I want to go, is she taking notes?
Yeah.
I would like to go on record. I think it's unreasonable for this committee to unilaterally deny a community member who's an engineer to at least be party to the discussions to keep us informed. Because we're not getting any information. Well, I'm not sure.
You
rejected that notion in an adequate way. I'd like to know, I would like to know if Mr. Solomon's request was received affirmatively or negatively.
Well, I can say it's affirmatively because they're going to meet with the two
engineers. It sounded like he was denied before. That's what it sounded like to me. I'd like a response.
They would meet with him before March 20th.
Before March 20th, there'll be a meeting between the two engineers and whoever. Jerry and Cheryl want to hit Mr. Olman, whoever wants to go with it.
Is that satisfactory?
Yeah.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you for asking the questions. No bad questions. There are only bad people who don't want to
answer. Sometimes there are absent answers, though.
Any motion to adjourn?
Second.
Yeah, it was added to our area to look at.
Right.